Yes, sir.
Now I am going to start.
Okay, fine.
Good afternoon, all of you. As a part of the today's webinar series on research methodology, on the fifth day today, we have with us an eminent person and researcher and scholar and well-known, renowned, experienced both corporate and academic level and research level, Dr. Mukul Burghatte, who is a professor at Punjab Rao Deshmukh Institute of Management and Technology and Research, Nagpur. Today, I would like to invite our Honorable Principal Sir, Dr. Saheb Rao Chavan Sir, to have some foreword for this webinar series on this occasion. Thank you, sir.
Sir, before that, just a moment, sir. Somnath, sir.
Chavan, sir, just can you give the headphone to Somnath, sir? Hello.
Shuru kar denge.
Sir, Chavan, sir.
Haan.
Hello.
Latest
PPT I have sent to Somnath, sir, just now. To unko bolna, Parikshit sir ko bolna, wo share kare. They'll share their PPT.
Chalo, theek hai, theek hai. चलो मैं 2 मिनट बोल लेता हूँ तेरे बारे में. हेलो मुकुल.
ओके.
शिक्षा मंडल द्वारा संचालित गोशे वाणिज्य महाविद्यालय वर्धा नेशनल वेबिनार सीरीज ऑन रिसर्च मेथोडोलॉजी एक्सपर्ट स्पीकर डॉक्टर मुकुल बुरघाटे प्रोफेसर MBA डॉक्टर पंजाबराव देशमुख इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ मैनेजमेंट टेक्नोलॉजी एंड रिसर्च नागपुर. डॉक्टर मुकुल बुरघाटे यांचा हातचा विषय जो आहे डाटा एनालिसिस एंड इंटरप्रिटेशन. सामान्यपणे महाविद्यालयाच्या विविध विभागाकडून ज्या वेगवेगळ्या पद्धतीने जे इंडक्शन प्रोग्राम तर त्यामधली एक सिरीज रिसर्च सेल द्वारा कोऑर्डिनेटर डॉक्टर KV सोमनाथ आणि IQAC कोऑर्डिनेटर प्रोफेसर परीक्षित अग्रवाल यांच्या माध्यमातून मुलांना रिसर्च स्कॉलर आणि रिसर्च फॅकल्टी या लोकांना रिसर्चशी संबंधित विविध विषयाशी संबंधित असणारी माहिती उपलब्ध करून द्यावी या हेतूने ऑनलाईनमध्ये नॅशनल वेबिनार सिरीज म्हणून रिसर्च मेथडॉलॉजी या विषयाशी संबंधित एक महत्त्वाचा भाग म्हणून डाटा ॲनालिसिस इंटरप्रिटेशन. कारण रिसर्च मेथडॉलॉजीमध्ये डाटा कलेक्शन केल्यानंतर त्याचा एक महत्त्वाचा भाग डाटा ॲनालिसिस करणे आणि त्याच्याशी संबंधित असणारं डाटा इंटरप्रिटेशन करणे हे दोन्ही अत्यंत महत्त्वाचे भाग असतात. ज्याशिवाय कन्क्लुजन किंवा सजेशन किंवा रिकमेंडेशन हा समोरचा जो अत्यंत महत्त्वाचा जो भाग असतो हा रिसर्च स्कॉलरसाठी आणि रिसर्च फॅकल्टीसाठी महत्त्वाचा त्या विषयाशी संबंधित असणारं नॉलेज या ठिकाणी आज आपल्याला उपलब्ध असलेले माझे मित्र डॉक्टर मुकुल बुरघाटे सर हे आपल्याला माहिती विश्लेषण आणि त्याच्याशी संबंधित असणारं इंटरप्रिटेशन कशा पद्धतीनं करायचं यासंबंधीची माहिती आपल्याला सविस्तरपणे या ठिकाणी देणार आहे. म्हणून मी महाविद्यालयाद्वारे आणि शिक्षा मंडळ परिवाराकडून डॉक्टर मुकुल बुरघाटे सरांचं सहर्ष स्वागत करत आहो आणि धन्यवाद देतो की आमच्या परिवाराशी वारंवार आम्ही ज्या ज्या वेळेला आमच्या महाविद्यालयाकडून वेगवेगळ्या विषयाशी संबंधित अशा विषयाचं सेमिनार किंवा जर नॉलेज आम्हाला पाहिजे असेल तर त्यावेळेला स्वतःहून एक पारिवारिक सभासद म्हणून डॉक्टर मुकुल बुरघाटे सर आमच्यासाठी वेळ काढून या ठिकाणी उपलब्ध राहतात. म्हणून पुनश्च महाविद्यालय आणि शिक्षा मंडळ परिवाराकडून त्यांचं मी स्वागत करतो आणि मी त्यांना धन्यवाद देतो की सर वारंवार आम्हाला तुमच्या नॉलेजची आणि तुमच्या सहकार्याची महाविद्यालयाला जी अपेक्षा आहे ती तुम्ही नेहमीच पूर्ण करता आणि म्हणून विशेष धन्यवाद. आणि आजचा जो विषय आहे तो तुम्ही आमच्या रिसर्च स्कॉलरसाठी आणि रिसर्च फॅकल्टीसाठी ते तुम्ही चांगल्या पद्धतीनं मांडाल याच्या शंका नाही, परंतु ते तुम्ही आम्हाला चांगल्या पद्धतीनं सविस्तरपणे त्यासंबंधीची माहिती द्याल ही अपेक्षा करून मी या ठिकाणी माझे 2 शब्द संपवतो.
धन्यवाद सर.
थँक्यू
सर. कॅन यू हां हॅलो.
हां, थँक्यू व्हेरी मच डॉक्टर एस आर चव्हाण सर, अवर प्रिन्सिपल सर ऑफ अवर जी एस कॉलेज ऑफ कॉमर्स वर्धा. नाव आय विल टेक दी ऑपॉर्च्युनिटी ॲज पर दी डायरेक्शन ऑफ अवर प्रिन्सिपल सर टू इंट्रोड्यूस अवर व्हॅल्युएबल अँड रिसोर्स पर्सन इन ए ब्रीफ मॅनर. बट इट इज नॉट सो ईझी टू ब्रीफ अबाउट डॉक्टर मुकुल बुरघाटे सर, बट स्टील आय ट्राय माय सेल्फ टू प्रोजेक्ट समथिंग अबाउट अवर valuable resource person.
Yes, Somnath sir, excuse me. Before you start, in fact, just now I have sent you the latest PPT. In fact, few changes I have made. It's there on your WhatsApp. If you can circulate it to Agrawal sir, he can start with that new PPT.
Okay.
Please. Okay. It is there on your WhatsApp.
Oh.
Okay. You just a few minor changes I have done. Not much of them. So that we can directly start after the introduction is over. Not this one, the other one. Abhi bheja maine aapke WhatsApp.
Acha, abhi bheja.
Abhi bheja. Yani do ko 5 minute kam hote jab bheja.
Ha, theek hai.
Theek hai, wo circulate kar
diya. Ha.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Now I'll go for a brief description of our resource person. The resource person name is Dr. Mukul A. Bhurghate. His qualifications are BE, FIE, MBA, MCOM, SET Commerce and PhD. He is a professor at Punjab Rao Deshmukh Institute of Management, Technology and Research, Nagpur. He is the program in charge of PhD, the Center for Higher Learning and Research. He is also the coordinator of IGNO, ODL Study Center. He is also the examination superintendent of the University Term and Exam as well as IGNO examination. He is having a professional membership of different organizations. He is fellow of Institute of Engineer of India, Calcutta. He is a life member of Indian Science Congress. He is a life member of Indian Commerce Association. He is a life member of National Human Resource Development. He is a life member of Anand Credit Cooperative Society. He is also a life member of Shri Shivaji Credit Cooperative Society. And he is also a consultant for several organizations. He is a consultant for Galaxy Solar Energy Private Limited, as well as an advisor and consultant to Shreyas Quality Management Systems. He is having an experience of 21 years, which include both teaching and administration. He is having a handful experience of 14 years in the research arena. He is the program in charge for the Center for Higher Learning and Research at Dhanwate National College, Nagpur. He is recognized as a supervisor for PhD in RTM Nagpur University, Nagpur. He is the lead editor of International Journal of Commerce and Management Studies, a peer-reviewed indexed journal. He is nominated as a research advisory committee member by the Honorable Vice Chancellor of Nagpur University for GS College of Commerce, Wardha and J.M. Patel College of Arts, Science and Commerce, Bhandara. He is having 9 research scholars awarded PhD and 4 are pursuing their presently PhD course. He is examiner for PhD Viva OC and Open Defense Examination of SNDT Women University Mumbai and SGV University Amaravati. Member of Department of Research Committee of OP Jindal University Raigarh Chandigarh Chhattisgarh. He is a recognized supervisor and examiner for MBA of different universities like RTMNU, IGNO and YCMOU, and he is also a research supervisor for MPhil Commerce from YCMU, MOU and RTMNU. He has guided more than 27 students of MPhil Commerce for the Nagpur University. He has to his credit one minor research project work as a principal investigator funded by the IQAC Dhanwate National College, Nagpur, on the small loan and its impact on livelihood of female domestic workers at Nagpur. He is a course coordinator for pre-PhD coursework conducted on 13th June to 23rd June 2017, conducted at DNC Nagpur in association with the Academic Staff College, RTM Nagpur, University Nagpur. He is also a chairperson and seminars all over the nation. He has attended 21 national and international seminars and workshops and chaired. He has published 34 research papers, out of which 12 are UGC listed journals and one is Scopus journal publication. He wrote 6 books on different areas like the study of advertising agencies in India, मार्केटिंग मैनेजमेंट ए कंप्लीट गाइड टू सेट एग्जामिनेशन पेपर वन प्रोडक्शन एंड मटेरियल्स मैनेजमेंट मैनेजरियल स्किल डेवलपमेंट मैनेजमेंट प्रोसेस इज ऑल्सो एन ऑथर ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल बिहेवियर एंड ही इज अ रिव्यूअर ऑफ 3 चैप्टर्स ऑफ प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ मैनेजमेंट पब्लिश्ड बाय पियर्सन एजुकेशन चेन्नई इन 2008 He is having his corporate profile also. He worked with NUCHEM Limited Pune as marketing executive and he also worked with ISO 9001 Gold Ganga Group of Construction Company Pune as a marketing executive. With these few words of his reference, I would like to request Dr. Mukul Burgate sir, who has kindly accepted our invitation for gracing this occasion. I request Mukul Burgate sir to start his proceedings and bless all of us, including our research scholars and PG students. Thank you very much, sir. I hand over this session for your presentation. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you very much. In fact, let us start with the presentation. It is almost 2:10 now. We have today's topic. All of you, I have already circulated the PPT with Somnath sir and Agrawal sir. My topic for today's presentation is data analysis and interpretation, which is the most important and trickiest part of any thesis or any research work. Whenever we take up a research work, this data analysis and interpretation decides the path of the conclusion, decides the path for conclusion, for findings, conclusion and suggestions. In fact, if data analysis and presentation goes in the right direction, if it is done correctly, our findings and our suggestion will be correct. Otherwise, everything will go wrong. And this is preceding, right? This is preceding after data collection. First part, I think that is already covered with you people, that is data collection. This comes after you have collected the primary data. Now here data analysis, I am talking about primary data only. Secondary data, usually we do not do analysis because it is ready-made data. It is readily available, which has to be published as it is. You cannot make changes in secondary data. Primary data, you need to analyze the data because whatever data we collect is in raw form. It is not compiled, it is not tabulated. So we have to analyze. Analyzing means putting the data in proper perspective. And interpretation is nothing but putting those numericals into text, putting the numerical value in written form, textual form. That is nothing but interpretation, which is usually is there below the spreadsheet or tables we call it, right? So next. Yeah, see, basically today's presentation I have designed for beginners only because the audience which I came to know includes students also. So if I go in depth, then probably 1 hour session is not sufficient for me. And understanding the statistical tools will be a bit difficult for the beginners. But here what we'll try is, we'll try to clear your concepts. We'll try to clear your fundamentals about data analysis and interpretation. That is what we'll try to do. That's why I've given this slide the marking as approaching data analysis and how to interpret data for the beginners. Beginners means जो नए लोग हैं, जो जस्ट शुरुआत कर रहे हैं रिसर्च के लिए. Probably this includes the research scholars also because they have not submitted their PhD yet. They have not been awarded PhD yet. So I will include them in beginners also. They can be included. I do not know how many paper you the research scholar has written, but if they have written, then they will be excluded from the beginners. They won't be there in beginners. But all the students, MBA students and MDiv students, they will come in the category of beginners according to me. Maybe somebody must be having additional knowledge, so that is a different part. Next slide. Next talks about, see, it is a famous quote given by one of the computer scientists, computer programmer. He has quoted that you can have data without information, but you cannot have information without data. Now, what does that mean? Let us see in this next slide. Next slide. See, data, basically data analysis is related to data. So first of all, we have to talk on, we have to think about what exactly is the data, how to define the data. So data, as we know, data is crude information and not knowledge by itself. It is a crude information which contains information presented in haphazard manner. So the sequence from data to knowledge, how does the sequence goes from data to knowledge, from data to information? First of all, we convert data to information, then information to facts, and finally from facts to knowledge, right? So data cannot be directly converted to knowledge. First of all, data has to be converted into information. For example, temperature, right? Aaj ka temperature 25 degrees centigrade hai Nagpur mein, right? So May mein it was 48 degrees centigrade. So these are all data, right? And if I compile this data in proper form, if I take from January to December, temperature, minimum temperature and highest temperature, I think you people must be seeing the weather app. बहुत बार आपन देखते हैं आज का टेम्परेचर क्या रहेगा, आज बारिश आएगी कि नहीं आएगी. देर आर प्लेंटी ऑफ एप्स विच आर अवेलेबल एंड विच गिव्स यू इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट अ पर्टिकुलर रीजन और एरिया, दैट व्हाट इज द रेनफॉल फॉर थ्रू आउट द ईयर, किस समय में बारिश आती है, किस समय में नहीं आती है, टेम्परेचर कैसा, हाइएस्ट टेम्परेचर कितना होता है, लोएस्ट टेम्परेचर कितना होता है. तो दिस डेटा इफ आई पुट इट इन प्रॉपर परस्पेक्टिव, लाइक फ्रॉम जनवरी टू डिसंबर, इफ आई पुट दिस डेटा and if I want highest and the lowest data, then it becomes information, right? Or if all of you getting me? If the data is put in proper perspective, it becomes information, and information become facts. मैं अगर खोल के देखता हूँ कोई weather app and if I want to see the temperature of 2003, for example, 2003, right? To see the temperature of 8 May, then it was 48 degrees centigrade, right? So this is the fact. Nobody can change this fact now. The data has been turned into information, and information has become now a fact. And finally, facts से अपने को knowledge मिलता है. तो मुझे पता चलता है कि मई में नागपुर का temperature सबसे highest होता है और December में सबसे lowest होता है. So this facts becomes now your knowledge. So you'll come to know नागपुर में कब जाना है और कब नहीं जाना है. या फिर नागपुर में इफ यू वांट टू विजिट ताड़ोपा, विच वुड बी द आइडियल सीजन टू कम इन, वेदर इट विल बी समर, बिकॉज समर द टाइगर साइटिंग इज मोर कंपेयर टू विंटर एंड रेनी सीजन. सो नाउ दिस फैक्ट हैज बिकम नॉलेज टू यू, यू आर नॉलेजेबल. यू कैन से नहीं ताड़ोपा आपको जाना है या नागजीरा का जंगल जाना है तो गो इन द मंथ ऑफ मे, बिकॉज एट दैट टाइम द टाइगर साइटिंग इज मोर. सो नाउ यू आर अ नॉलेजेबल पर्सन, यू कैन एडवाइज अदर पीपल. So see how this data gets converted into knowledge. Next slide. So data to knowledge, that journey is very important. If we put the data in proper perspective, then and then only we can get knowledge out of it. Otherwise, data in itself is nothing but garbage. जैसे कंप्यूटर को बोला जाता है ना, गार्बेज इन गार्बेज आउट. अब कंप्यूटर में जो फिट करोगे वही बाहर आएगा, नथिंग न्यू विल कम. ओके, सो लेट अस मूव टू द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड. डेटा बिकम्स इंफॉर्मेशन व्हेन इट बिकम्स रिलेवेंट टू योर डिसीजन प्रॉब्लम. डेटा बिकम्स इंफॉर्मेशन, इंफॉर्मेशन बिकम्स फैक्ट व्हेन डेटा कैन सपोर्ट इट. बट डेटा रिवेल्स फैक्ट्स, डेटा से ही फैक्ट्स निकल के आते हैं, राइट? सो दिस फैक्ट्स आर इंपॉर्टेंट इन डिसीजन मेकिंग. वी कैन अप्लाई सर्टन स्टैटिस्टिकल टूल्स विद सर्टन डिग्री ऑफ कॉन्फिडेंस टू रीच अ डिसीजन. कोई डिसीजन मेकिंग करना है अपने को तो इट इज बेस्ड ऑन द डेटा ओनली, बट डेटा हैज टू बी कन्वर्टेड इंटू इंफॉर्मेशन, इंफॉर्मेशन इंटू फैक्ट्स एंड फैक्ट्स इंटू नॉलेज. नेक्स्ट स्लाइड. बिफोर दैट वी हैव वन ग्राफ. प्रायर टू दिस सर, वन मोर स्लाइड इज देयर. इसके पहले के साथ, सो दिस इज हाउ आई हैव एक्सप्लेन इज गिवन इन अ ग्राफ. डेटा, इंफॉर्मेशन, फैक्ट, नॉलेज, यू हैव टू कीप दिस इन माइंड ऑलवेज. So this is the graphs gives the x-axis is level of improvement on decision making, and the y-axis is level of exactness of statistical model. Now what does this mean? Level of exactness of statistical model. This means that the more the refined data you do, the more exactly आप statistical model लगा सकते हैं और उसका output आपको अच्छा मिलेगा. More the data is refined. If knowledge is there, then the statistical model many times won't be needed also. You can make a decision out of it. Right? So but knowledge will give you certain good decision making, which will be handy for you in making personal decision as well as business decision. Depends on what sort of data you are analyzing. Next slide. So data, now let us see the definition of analysis and interpretation. What does these two terms mean? Because our today's topic is data analysis and data interpretation. Analysis means the ordering, manipulating and summarizing the data to obtain answers to research questions. Research questions kya hote hain apne, jo apna objective set karte hain apne. Whatever research we do, we always have research objectives, we have hypotheses, which are all nothing but research questions. So this research question ya research problem bhi bolte hain apan usko. So this research questions or research problem can be studied and tested so that whatever objectives we have set for our research can be studied through the analysis. Interpretation. What does this interpretation means? Interpretation means it gives the result of analysis. After the analysis is done, you can interpret, you can conclude something out of the analysis. Interpretation gives the result of analysis, which makes inferences or conclusions pertained to the research related studies and draw conclusion about this relationships. So after the analysis of the data is done, you can interpret based on whatever trends, we call it trends and patterns, are drawn. You can make the final conclusion about the data you have collected depending on the research problem. That is very important. Research question, right? Your objectives, your hypothesis, you have to take into consideration all this thing, and based on this can go draw conclusion. You can interpret. You can interpret. Okay then, next slide. Now this is a basic difference. See, we are using these two words, analysis and interpretation. What is the difference between data analysis and interpretation? Data collection is the systematic recording of information. Data analysis involves working to uncover the pattern. Data analysis involves working to uncover patterns and trends in the data sets, and data interpretation involves explaining these patterns and trends. It's very important. Fine, let us start. Actually, I got disconnected. Fine. Anyway, next slide, sir. Planning for data analysis. Next slide, sir, please. Yeah. Data analysis. So what we have seen is data analysis and data interpretation. We have studied these two terms. Both are different, but they are overlapping. Data analysis or data analysis, maybe you try to find out a pattern and trend. At the same time, in interpretation also, it is overlapping. Why? Because there also you try to find pattern and trend, but in textual format. Analysis may you play with numbers, you play with figures, but in interpretation you work with text. All of you know what the text means. Whatever is written right now to answer the research question is a text actually. What is the purpose? What is the purpose of data analysis? To answer the research question and to help determine the trends and relationships amongst the variable. I've used this word trends and patterns, right? It is to help to determine the trends and the relationship between amongst the variables. Now, what does this thing mean? Relationship among the variables. What are variables? Like height and weight. A person's height and weight, you can correlate it. किसी ज्यादा हाइट रहेगी तो ऑब्वियसली वेट विल बी मोर नॉट नेसेसरी ऑलवेज ट्रू बट द ट्रेंड सेज दैट इफ योर हाइट इज मोर देन योर वेट विल बी प्रोबेबली मोर राइट और यू कैन टेक अनदर वेरिएबल्स लाइक इनकम एंड एक्सपेंडिचर आर द टू वेरिएबल इनकम मैं क्या कितना कमाता हूँ और मैं कितना खर्चा करता हूँ तो इफ माई इनकम इज मोर देन डेफिनेटली माई एक्सपेंडिचर विल बी मोर इफ माई इनकम इज लो देन Definitely, my expenditure will be low, my saving will be low, and my income is high, my saving will be high. So these are variables. These are nothing but variables. We call it variables. This word we will be using it frequently, and you should understand the exact meaning of variables. Variables can be anything. As I said, it can be age, right? It can be your blood pressure. It can be your heart rate. So these are all variables. Next slide, sir. So steps in data analysis. What are the basic steps before data collection? The researcher should accomplish the following. Before you start the data collection, आपने क्या करना है और क्या नहीं करना है? Determine the method of data analysis. आपकी data analysis की method क्या रहेगी? वो सोच के data collect करोगे तो काफी आसान जाएगा आगे. Otherwise, if you just collect the data and after that you start thinking कि अभी what sort of data analysis I should use. Then things may get complicated. But if you keep in mind that I'll be using such and such method for data analysis, which we'll be talking in our further slides, so your data collection will be proper. Determine how to process the data. Consult a statistician. This is important. See, many times all we are MBA student or MCOM student, we are not statistician. Statisticians are usually are those person who play with figures. Mathematician, we call it, right? Usually BSc Mathematics or MSc Mathematics. These people are usually statisticians. So you can always take help of the statistician. There is nothing wrong in it. Even I am not an expert in many of the statistical tools. So I often consult my friends who are statisticians, and nothing wrong in that. You can pay also if somebody is not. See, often they won't be giving you free advice. तो कई बार वो चार्ज भी करते तो नथिंग रॉन्ग इन दैट इफ यू आर नॉट एबल टू डू द स्टैटिस्टिकल पार्ट प्रॉपरली यू कैन कंसल्ट अ स्टैटिस्टिशियन प्रिपेयर अ डमी टेबल टेबल्स ऑल ऑफ यू नो द अदर वर्ड इज स्प्रेडशीट्स होता है एक्सेल में राइट सो प्रिपेयर अ डमी टेबल आफ्टर डेटा कलेक्शन यू हैव टू प्रोसेस द डेटा प्रिपेयर टेबल्स एंड ग्राफ्स दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट हाउ आर यू गोइंग टू प्रोसेस द डेटा थ्रू टेबल्स एंड ग्राफ्स आपको पहले तो टेबल्स तैयार करने पड़ेंगे Based on that table, the computer or the Excel or SPSS or Python, it will generate graphs for you, different graphs for you. It can be bar chart, it can be histogram, it can be pie chart, right? It can be trending lines. So it depends on what sort of platform you are using and what is the purpose. How presentable you want your data. So it all depends on that. Analyze and interpret findings. After that, you have to analyze and interpret the findings. Consult again the statistician. Again, this is very important. Prepare for editing and prepare for presentation. The final outcome will be presented to the target audience. It depends if for a PhD scholar, his presentation will be the final defense open Viva OC examination. Or for an MBA student, the presentation can be on the project which he is doing. Because project again, see the line of action remains same. Whatever research you are doing, especially for commerce, management, and social science, the line of action remains same for all we people. Fine for science people or engineering background people or medicine people, the line of action might differ because there most of the things are done through laboratories. But here in social science or in humanities, I can call it. Or in commerce and management, the line of action for research or the plan for research will remain one and the same. The framework will remain same. It won't be changing. Next slide. Kind of data analysis. Now this is important. You have to remember there are only two types of data analysis. One is descriptive analysis and one is inferential analysis. descriptive analysis. Next slide. We'll first of all talk about descriptive analysis. What exactly is descriptive analysis? So we should know data analysis. We are talking about data analysis, but data analysis is again divided into two types. Descriptive analysis refers to the description of data from a particular sample. This refers to the description of data. Now what it is? Hence the conclusion must refer only to the sample. It is a description of the data. In other words, this summarizes the data and describes the sample characteristics, like what is the height and weight of a particular class, right? Average height and average weight of a particular class, or for example, what is the average mark scored in a particular subject? It can be economics, it can be marketing management. So what is the average mark scored? So it will characterize the sample which you are going to study. Descriptive statistics are numerical values. You have to keep in mind that descriptive statistics are numerical values obtained from the sample that gives meaning to the data collected. Numerical values obtained from the sample that gives meaning to the data collected. So this is descriptive statistics is nothing but description through numerical values. Next slide. So here, classification of descriptive analysis, it can be through frequency distribution, a systematic arrangement of numerical value from lowest to highest or highest to lowest. Like just my temperature ka example liya tha. Lowest temperature kab rehta hai? December mein, and highest temperature is in the month of May. And from highest to lowest or lowest to highest. The formula is very simple. EF is equal to N, where E is sum of, F is the frequency, and N is the sample size. The sample which you have taken from the population or from the universe. Next slide. Another method which you can use is measure of central tendency. Measure of central tendency. Again, this see descriptive statistics is usually related to numericals only. Here we can use kinds of average like mode, median, and mean. What is mode? Mode is the numeric value in a distribution that occurs most frequently. Agar ek class mein out of 100, 50 marks ya 60 marks sabko jyada mile hai, so that will be the mode of that particular class. If many students gets 50 marks, and which is the highest, if 60 is the highest figure, 60 marks agar 20 logo ko milte hai aur baaki logo ko 20 se kam rehte hai, are scored by 10 people only. So 60 will become the mode for that particular class. Median. Median is what? Average position in a distribution of a number. It is the middle position or the average position in the number, middle of that chart. If you are having the scores of all the students of the class, then probably the middle number. The middle number means aapka class agar 60 ka hai, so 30th jo student rahega, that will be the median. Then mean. Mean is nothing but the average, actually, the point on the score scale that is equal to the sum of score divided by total number of score. That is nothing but average. We call it mean or average, right? So the formula is simple. X, the mean, is equal to summation of each individual row score and divided by number of cases. I mean, total population we are talking about. The universe we are talking about. So we have to divide it by the universe. Next slide. And measure of central variability. This is again one of the platform you can use for descriptive analysis. Statistics that concerns the degree to which the score is a distribution are different from or similar to each other. The score jaisa kitna farak hai class ke score mein. Zero kitne logo ko mila hai aur 100 kitne logo ko mila hai. Ya fir 5 mark kisko kitne logo ko mile aur 90 marks kitne ko mile hai. So this shows the variability of the sample. Right, and all here we are using is value only. Next slide. Classification, again the last is bivariate descriptive analysis. We won't go into much detail of it here. Correlation is important. I'll be talking about correlation. Correlation is nothing but variables. Jo maine bola tha, do variables ko agar aap jodna chahte hai, like height and weight, I have given you example, right? Month and temperature. So if you, the most common method of describing the relationship between the two measures or variable is the another word for this. So if you want to correlate these two, like crime rate and crime rate and illiteracy, right? In a particular city, these are two measures or two variables. If you want to correlate, you use this correlation analysis. We'll be talking about it in further detail, right? Next slide. Next slide. Again, this. The second kind of data analysis or type of data analysis is inferential analysis. Next slide. Inferential analysis, the use of statistical tools, statistical tests, either to test for significant relation among the variable or to find statistical support for the hypothesis. Now here what is done is, inferential analysis mein kya hota hai, ki you try to use certain statistical test to find out the relationship among the variable. Now this test can be simple proportion test, it can be t-test, it can be ANOVA test, right? It can be chi-square test, or it can be simple correlationship test. We'll be talking about these five types of tests which are used for analyzing the data and which becomes part of this type of analysis. Next slide. Level of significance. What is this level of significance? Now, inferential analysis we have studied. Descriptive analysis was nothing but playing with numbers. You just talk about numbers, right? Mean, mode, median, average, marks, kitne score hue class mein, yeah? What is the mode of the class, the score that has been scored by the students. Now here, level of significance is something related to inferential analysis. Inferential analysis says that if I want to know the people who would like to buy blue cars, nile ya fir chalo white color ki car lete hain apan, people who could purchase white color car, and if the population of that particular city is 10 lakh, then probably I'll try to take out a sample out of it, right? Main pure 10 lakh logo ko jaake nahi puch sakta ki aap bataiye which car would you prefer. If given a chance, if you have a budget, then whether you will be purchasing white car, white colored car, right? White colored car, are you going to purchase that? Now going to all 10 lakh people and asking them is not practically possible, not financially viable, time consuming. So what I do is, at random I'll select samples. 10 lakh mein se main thara lunga ki mera sample size, chalo main 5% sample size, chalo 10% le leta hu. So probably I'll go and meet, again for 10 lakhs 10% is very high. So I'll like to go for 1%. So 1% will become 1000, right? So this 1000 people I'll take as a sample, and I'll ask these people, yeah, mere paas meri capacity nahi hai, I don't have time, I don't have money, then I can reduce the sample size also. I can take 100 only at random from each area I can take, right? It depends what is the objective of my study exactly, whether I'd like to study upper middle class or lower middle class or higher middle class, and which car I'm asking them to purchase, which car's opinion I'm asking. So accordingly you have to decide on your sample size. So this particular 1000 people, or for example 100 people, will become my sample size. Now this sample size, I'll ask question, and if 50% people say that we'd like to purchase white Swift Desire, right? I have asked the question that whether you'd like to purchase white Swift Desire, then if 50% says, then it becomes 100 ke kitne ho jata hai, 50, right? So 50% chances of 50% of my sample size says they'd like to purchase that particular car. Now this 50%, I'll make it applicable to my 10 lakh people with certain amount level of confidence, level of significance. मैं इसमें margin of error जोड़ दूंगा कि हो सकता है कि ये sample पूरा representative नहीं हो, हो सकता है कि 50 से ज़्यादा लोग खरीद ले, I mean to say 50%, more than 50% out of 10 lakhs. So this become margin of error. It is usually represented, this value is represented typically by 0.01 or 0.05. So I can take a margin of error as 5 or 2, depends on how much error I'd like to take into account. कि मैंने बोला तो था 50%, but लोगों ने जो खरीदा है, that is more than that. More than 60% have purchased that car. So I have to add that margin of error also, which is nothing but the level of significance. Other word uses alpha also for testing the null hypothesis. Next slide. Now these are the tests. Actually, we all people are afraid of. Usually, we take help of the statistician. But let me tell you, these are not at all very difficult. If you just study properly, you can apply these tests. All these tests are there available on most of the freely available software, Excel, SPSS, SPSS. Even though it is not freely available, but many softwares they give this test freely. Now these are the five important tests. T test. One test we have already studied, correlation test, right? So T test. What is this? Is used to examine the difference between mean of two independent groups. It is used to examine the two independent groups or categories. For example, height and weight, jo maine bola tha, I can take categories like male and female, and I can take age as one of the category. If I want to test something, if I want to find a relation between male, female, height and weight and their age group, it can be youngster, it can be adult, it can be old people. So the T test is usually applied. ANOVA, when is this test applied? ANOVA kab use ki jati hai? Is used to test the significance of difference between two means of two or more groups. Jaise male and female height and weight, and then their actual height and weights. Right. So if I want to know the relationship between these two, I'll use ANOVA as a test for testing, as a statistical tool for testing the what is the relationship between, whether it's a positive relation or negative relation, or there is no relation at all. That is null hypothesis. If there is a positive relation, then we usually accept, or negative, even if negative relation, we accept alternate hypothesis. We reject null hypothesis. And if there is no relation, that is zero, then we usually reject alternate hypothesis, we select null hypothesis. Chi-square test, what is this? This test is used to test the hypothesis about the proportion of element that falls into various cell of a contingency table. Elements, what are these element? Chi-square test. It is used when these all tests are there to know the, find the relationship between variables, right? Variables and numbers, okay? Next slide. Why interpretation? Now let us move to interpretation. Ultimately data analysis, we end up by using statistical tool. We would like to validate whatever we have collected, the data we have collected. First of all is presentation. As I said, you have to present your data properly in a tabular format, in a spreadsheet format. Then you can present it to two types of methods of analysis. First was descriptive. It can be through numericals. It can be through graphs, charts, right? It can be through mean, mode, median. It can be through standard deviation. And then inferential analysis. What we do is we apply various tests to know the relationship between various variables. So there we end with data analysis part. Once the data analysis is over, immediately analysis in itself doesn't mean anything. It is of no relevance if you are not able to interpret the data properly based on your objectives, based on your hypothesis which you have said. So you have to do proper interpretation. Interpretation is essential for the simple reason that the usefulness and the utility of research finding lie in proper interpretation. Your research finding, your conclusion will all depend on how you interpret the data. So all you have to do is, if you get confused, you have to again refer back to your title of the research. You have to refer back to your objective. You have to refer back to your hypothesis. This is what you have to do. So it is being considered a basic component of research process because of the following research. Why is interpretation important? It is for the following reason. It is through interpretation that a researcher can well understand the abstract principle that works behind the finding. Through this, he can link up his finding with those of the other studies. Mere jo study kar raha hu, similar studies kisne ki hai. So it is through this interpretation, I can compare my finding, my research with the research of other researcher. This way the continuity of research can be maintained. It is through this interpretation only the meaning of the continuity of research can be maintained. Next slide, sir. Again, this is interpretation list to what? Interpretation meaning, just a moment, meaning, next slide, sir. This is not important. Next slide, sir. Interpretation leads to establishment. What does it lead to? Right? It leads to what? The interpretation is a device. It is nothing but a device. Interpretation is a device through which the factors that seems to explain what has been observed by the researcher in the course of study can be better understood, and it also provides a theoretical conception which can serve as a guide for further research or researchers. It can, once you interpret, then only this will act as a guide for other researcher, or it can act as a guide for yourself for doing further research. जो आपने ना advance इसके आगे और research किया जा सकता है, तो it will act as a guide. Actually, once I do the interpretation part. Methods of data interpretation. What are various methods? Direct visual observation of raw data. I just go through the raw data and I can interpret. Just a moment. So go to slide number 31. Methods of data interpretation. Methods, What are the different methods of data interpretation? There are various methods of data interpretation. First is direct visual observation of raw data. I just go through the raw data and I can just interpret ki, how is the temperature of Simla, right? What is the temperature of Simla right now? Because I do have raw data with me. Ki Simla mein usually temperature is below 30 throughout the year. So based on raw data also I can interpret what can be the temperature right now of Simla right now. After organizing the data in tables, we have to organize the data in table, then only we can interpret. Otherwise it is not possible. After making graphical representation, as I said earlier, you can have bar chart, pie chart, skip through, you can interpret that this many people, this many percentage of people have scored more than 50 marks, or this many people, percentage of people have passed. And you can interpret that this many number of students have failed in that particular subject. So this is through, you can do this through graphical representation also. It can be done by after calculation using numerical and statistical methods. जो अपने inferential analysis में ये किया था, statistical tools अपने जो study की test, t-test, then we have ANOVA, then we have correlation, then we have chi-square test. So it can be interpreted through this various tests also. These tests are meant for that only, for interpretation. इसमें से आप interpret कर सकते कि how many people would like to purchase the white cars. So you can interpret by applying this statistical tools. And after mathematical modeling, you can model it out also. In Excel you can put it, you can prepare a model, you can prepare a formula that is called as mathematical modeling. That if I keep on adding something, I can have a formula in Excel and which will act as a data interpretation. Next slide. So what? Next slide, sir. Precautions in interpretation. This is very important. What precaution as a researcher you should take when you are going to interpret the data? So there are many precautions the researchers have to take. One should always remember that even if the data are properly collected and analyzed, wrong interpretation would lead to inaccurate conclusion. If the interpretation is not proper, then your conclusion and obviously your finding and your suggestion, everything will be incorrect or inaccurate. It won't be correct, right? So it is through this interpretation only we go to findings and conclusion and then suggestion of the study. It is therefore absolutely essential that the task of interpretation be accomplished with the patients in an impartial manner and also in correct perspective. घाई घाई में अपने को interpret नहीं करना, you have to think, you have to give it a thought. सोच के ही interpret करोगे तो ही आपके findings और conclusion and ultimately your suggestion will be helpful to the stakeholders, जिसके लिए भी आप research कर रहे हैं उनके काम में आएंगे. Otherwise all this thing will go haywire and it will go in wrong direction. Ultimately your entire research will look shabby. It won't look good. So this proper interpretation is very important to put everything in correct perspective. Next slide. For correct interpretation, what precaution one should take? For correct interpretation, what are the probable precaution that a researcher has to take? Researcher must pay attention to the following points for correct interpretation. At the outset, the researcher must invariably satisfy himself that the data are appropriate, trustworthy, adequate for drawing inferences. The data is correct, adequate, trustworthy, properly correct kiya gaya hai. Fake data nahi hai. Agar fake data hoga, to everything will go again wrong. So it has to be appropriate. Appropriate means it has to be matching with your objective and hypothesis. Ab koi bhi data collect karoge, if I want to find out, as I said, one example, white car, for example, white colored Swift Desire car, if I want to know, and if I keep on asking questions like, it can be a relevant question like, how are you married? It has nothing to do with buying of a car. Are you married or unmarried? If this question is not appropriate, so this will not lead to anything. So my objective, I have to keep in mind my objective, and accordingly I have to frame the questions. That is important. Okay. Now the data reflects good homogeneity, and that the data is homogeneous. Homogeneous means it is not heterogeneous. It is similar in nature. It has to be similar in nature. I am to say haphazard way mein data nahi collect karna hai. It has to have homogeneity. Proper analysis has to be done through statistical methods. Proper analysis के लिए आप statistical tool use करने हैं, t-test, acid, ANOVA test, correlation, right? Proportion test can be there. Then it can be your chi-square test. These are all five important tests which you all have to remember, which all you have to keep in mind. The researcher must remain cautious about the errors that can possibly arise in the process of interpreting the result. एरर्स जो आएंगे आपकी इसमें क्रिपल डाउन होंगे, अल्फा एरर, बीटा एरर्स, राइट? सो यू हैव टू कीप इन माइंड ऑल दिस एरर्स. अल्फा एरर इज यूजुअली रिलेटेड टू नल हाइपोथेसिस. सो यू हैव टू कीप इन माइंड द लेवल ऑफ कॉन्फिडेंस एंड द लेवल ऑफ सिग्निफिकेंस विच यू आर गोइंग टू यूज फॉर व्हेन यू आर गोइंग टू अप्लाई दिस स्टैटिस्टिकल टूल्स. सो लर्निंग दिस स्टैटिस्टिकल टूल्स इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, एंड दिस टूल्स is to be used when you have to know that also. So this, all these things are very important. I hope all of you followed whatever I've said. I hope all of you have understood. Now we are open for your doubts and queries. If you have any, you can one by one post it on this thing, or you can post it on your YouTube. I know all of you are this thing is being streamed on YouTube, so you can post your queries on YouTube. I'll try to answer to my level best, one by one. Thank you so much, sir. Right.
Should not arise, and at the same time the total efforts played for the research activity will go in vain. And like experienced and exposed researchers like you rightly take the note of all these things, and suggested all of our research scholars as well as the faculty members who are doing for research projects to go for a meaningful way of doing the research from the start to the end. And it is very much advisable to have these sessions from eminent speakers and resource persons like you, who have a versatile experience of the research arena, not only in the social sciences as well as in the business studies also. And with this few words, I would like to now hand over my request to Professor Parishkrit Agarwal sir, who is the backbone of this entire webinar series, to express his views on behalf of the research scholar. You know that he is also a research scholar of our study center.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your session. Really, your session will help us for our
PhD. I hope, sir, I have not done it very fast. I hope all of you have understood what I said.
Yes, sir. We have clearly understood, and it will help us as we are doing the PhD. It will help us a lot, sir. Thank you very much.
Okay. Welcome. You are most welcome. In fact, student have questions? The audience have any questions?
No, sir. Then we will mail you that questions.
Yeah, that would be very, very fine.
Yes.
Very, it will save our time also. Yes. And in fact, they can call me also if they want with their questions. Not right now, today. Tomorrow, 10 a.m. onwards, they can definitely call me. 10 to 3, ask them to call me, whatever questions they are having. Not only pertaining to data analysis and interpretation,
yes,
the questions can be based to anything related to research.
Yes,
I think I'll be able to answer those questions.
Yes,
because many of us are not very clear with the research part. Actually, in fact, we complete our PhD, we submit, we get awarded also. But we are hollow when it comes to research. Actually, our concepts are not clear. So I hope all of you followed what I have said. Thank you so much, sir, for inviting me. Hope again to meet you next time when you again conduct a webinar series. In fact, Chauhan sir has asked me to conduct one, which I'll be doing on paper presentation. I hope all of you will join that particular workshop. It will be 2 days workshop, which I am planning on November 21st and 22nd, three speakers, learned speaker are going to talk upon how to write a paper, because that is a area where we as a Vidarbhian are lacking far behind compared to our peer group in Pune and Mumbai or other areas, Bengaluru for example. We don't have that high quality paper.
Yes.
Forget about others. Even I personally believe myself also, I'm not written the quality of paper I should be writing actually.
Yes, sir.
So even I'm going to attend that.
Yes.
So I hope all of you join for that workshop.
Yes, sir.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, sir.